Hello everyone. In this session, we will see Quinn McCluskey using don't care terms. What are the different steps to be followed when we solve Quinn McCluskey using don't care terms? The first step is to construct a list of min terms and don't care terms classified according to the number of ones. See, first we need to construct a list of min terms and don't care terms classified according to the number of ones. And one more thing you have to remember is indicate the don't care terms by using star symbol. So whichever are the don't care terms, those are to be indicated by the star. And one more thing is don't care terms are never included as the prime implicants by themselves. The remaining all procedure remains the same. So after this, we compare the group n with the group n plus 1, that is adjacent groups are compared, and then as per our previous procedure, the only one change is permitted, and wherever the bit change occurs, that has to be indicated by the dash. And remaining all bits are as it is. This process has to be repeated until no further grouping can occur. Then finally, we are constructing the prime implicant table to determine the essential prime implicants. And one more thing is, don't care terms do not need to be covered. Let us solve one problem. Simplify the following using Quinn-McCluskey technique. The problem given is S is equal to f of wxyz is equal to sigma 1 3 13 15 plus sigma d 8 9 10 11. See here, 8 9 10 11 are the don't care terms given. First, let us write the binary equivalent of all the min terms as well as the don't care terms. So in this table, this has been arranged in the order. See here, 1 min term, 1, then 3 we have. Then the don't care terms are 8, 9, 10, 11. 8, 9, 10, 11. And see here, those are indicated by the star symbol. These are the don't cares. Next we have two more min terms, that is 13 and 15. Let us write the binary equivalent of each of this. One is 0, 0, 0, 1. 3 is 0, 0, 1, 1. Then 8 we have as 1, 0, 0, 0. Then 9 is 1, 0, 0, 1. 10, 1, 0, 1, 0. 11 is 1011, then 13 is 1101, then last 15 is 1111. Now we have written the binary equivalent of each of the min terms and the don't care terms. As usual, as per our regular procedure, we have to have the groups of the same number of ones. For example, here we have min term 1 and min term don't care term 8. Those can be grouped together because they have only one 1 in them. So similarly, we have to group the terms of 2 1s, then 3 1s, and then 4 1s. Only thing you have to remember is don't care terms are to be indicated by the star or asterisk symbol. Let us do that. As per our normal procedure, let us form the groups of min terms and the don't care terms so that each group contains the same number of ones. So group number 1 contains 1, min term 1, and the don't care term 8. Next we have group number 2. Group number 2 is nothing but the min terms or don't care terms which have the two number of ones. They are, you see here, 3 contains two ones, Similarly, 9 contains 2 ones and also 10 contains 2 ones. If you see the 3 ones, then 11 and 13 contains 3 ones and finally 15 contains 4 ones. We will group them together here. So 2 ones, group number 2 is 3, 9 and 10, whereas 9 and 10 are the don't care terms. Similarly, group number 3 is 11, which is the don't care term, and then 13, and group number 4 is 15. Let us write these variables W, X, Y, Z. 1 is 0, 0, 0, 1. Then 8 we have as 1, 0, 0, 0. Then 3 is 0, 0, 1, 1. 9 is 1, 0, 0, 1. Then 10 is 1, 0, 1, 0. 11, 1, 0, 1, 1. Then 13 is 1, 1, 0, 1. And finally 15 is 1, 1, 1, 1. Now in this step, we have grouped the min terms or the don't care terms containing the same number of ones. As per our regular procedure, now we have to compare and combine the min terms and the don't care terms where we can combine where only one position change occurs. Let us do that. Here if you see, if you compare group number 1 and group number 2, which terms we can combine? If you see the min term 1 and min term 3. The procedure remains the same. 1 has to be compared with 3, 9, 10. Similarly, 8 has to be compared with 3, 9 and 10. So wherever there is only one position change, those can be combined together. Only thing you have to remember is the don't care terms are to be indicated by the star or the asterisk symbol. Let us combine the terms, compare and combine the terms. So if you see 1 and 3, this 1 and 3. Then what we have here? We have only one change over here, that is this one and this zero. This zero is same as this zero. This zero is same as this zero. And this one is same as this one. So we can combine them together. We have group number 1 as min terms 1 and 3. Then how do we write the variables? Variables can be written as 0, 0, dash, 1. Now you need to tick mark this and this. Similarly, if you compare 1 and 9. Now what you have here in 1 and 9? You have only one bit change. See here, this is 1, this is 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, and this is 0 and 1. So only one bit change is occurring. Therefore, we can combine the terms 1 and 9. And that 1 and 9 has to be written as 1, and 9 is a don't care term. So 9 star or 9 asterisk. Now you have dash 0, 0, 1. Tick mark this. Whichever are covered, those are to be tick marked. The procedure remains the same as we have done for the previous Quinn-McCluskey techniques. Then we can combine 8 and 9. 8 is also the don't care term and 9 is also the don't care term. So our variables are 1, 0, 0 and 1. Next is 8 and 10 can be combined together. Those are represented as a don't care terms. Then our variables are 1, 0, dash and 0. So as and when we combine, we have to tick mark. 8 is combined. Similarly, 10 is also combined. So that is the group number 1. Similarly, for group number 2, we can combine 3 and 11. 11 is the don't care term. So it is dash 0, 1 and 1. We can combine 9 and 11, both are don't care terms. Our variables are now 1, 0, dash and 1. Here 3 and 11 are combined. So 3 is already tick marked. You have to tick mark 11. Next 9 and 11 are combined. Both 9 and 11 are tick marked. Next we have to combine 9 and 13. Our variables remain 1, dash, 0 and 1. So 13 is combined, tick mark 13. Next we can combine 10 and 11. Both are don't care terms. Our variables remain 1, 0, 1, dash. So 10 is also tick marked, 13 is also, 11 is also tick marked, and even the 13 is also tick marked. So this is the group number 2. Now group number 3. In group number 3, we can combine 11 and 15. 11 is the don't care term, 15 is the min term. Our variables are 1, dash, 1, 1. So tick mark that. 11 is already tick marked. So tick mark 15. Next we can combine 13 and 15. These 13 and 15 are the min terms. Our variables are 1, 1, dash and 1. So now we have combined 2 min terms. Our next step is we have to combine 4 min terms and don't care terms together it is. So here when we have the don't care terms, min terms and don't care terms are combined together. The procedure remains the same. So now which we can combine? So again our procedure is you have to find where the dash is same, in which position the dash is same. So you need to compare group 1 with group 2. So find out where the dash is same. See here we have the dash and here we have the dash. The dash is into the same position. See for this and for this. If you compare these two, the dash is in the same position. This is 1, this is 1, this is 0, this is 0, and there is a single bit change, 0 to 1. So if such condition exists, then we can combine such terms, and the process has to be repeated. Only thing is the don't care terms are to be indicated by the star mark. Let us combine those. So group 1 is 1, 3, 9 is a don't care and 11 is the don't care. So you have dash, 0, dash and 1. And as and when you combine, you have to tick mark those. So like this, you have to compare each of the groups. Wherever the dash is same and wherever there is a single bit change, then you have to combine such terms. After combining such terms, you will get it as one more term can be combined in group 1, that is 8, 9, 10 and 11. So our variables are 1, 0, dash and dash. In group number 2, we can combine 9, 11, 13 and 15. Variables are 1, dash, dash and 1. So now this is the next step and final step is prime implicant table. The process remains same. We have to find out which are the PI terms. Which are the PI terms here? This is one PI term and this is the another PI term. This we need not have to consider because all are the don't care terms. Here none of the min terms are present. So this need not be considered. We need to consider this and we need to consider this. Now if you see this, What is a PI term you will get? This says x bar and this says z. So this will be x bar z. Similarly, if you consider this, you will get it as w and z. And the mean terms and don't care terms, mean terms covered by this are 1 and 3 and the mean terms covered by this are 13 and 15. Let us write that. The PI terms are x bar z and the decimal list is 1, 3, 9 and 11. Similarly, we have next PI term is wz and the decimal list is 9, 11, 13 and 15. See here, if you see here, we need to consider only the min terms, not the don't care terms. Let us mark the cross mark. In the first, with the first PI term, the min terms covered are 1 and 3. Similarly, with the second PI terms, the min terms covered are 13 and 15. If you check each of the column, whether this column, this column, this column, or this column, there is a single cross mark. Since there is a single cross mark in each of the column, all those are to be circled. It means that all are the, both are the essential prime implicants. Therefore, our equation is S is equal to x bar z or wz. This is the simplified expression using Quinn-McCluskey with the don't care terms. Thank you.